Hey guys, my name is Freedom. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you all of the basic modeling, rigging, and animations in Blender. You can see this is a simple 3D model. At the same time, I already rigged it. I already set a skeletons for this 3D model. And finally, I also already made a really simple 3D animations. So in this tutorial, I'm going to show you all in once. Just step by step, really simple, from the simple modeling to simple rigging and finally simple animations all in once. If you are a beginner in Blender today, this is really a crucial part of the modeling, rigging and animations process that you should master it so that you can make anything, any animations, any 3D models, and any rigging parts in Blender. So first, I'm going to click the empty area in Blender 4.2 and press A to select all and press delete to delete everything. And to start the modeling, first I'm going to add a mesh, add a cube. By using this a very simple 3D model, this is a 3D mesh. First, click and select it, go to the edit modes, and I'm going to just click here so that I can select the face. This is just a very simple concept go through. I'm going to make it long, make it longer like this. Then this is what we call a loop cut. Click and I choose here just to make it become many loop cuts. Then back to the selections. Then now this is to select the face. Now you can see there are so many. So next, I'm going to click, select this face and press E to extrude it out and perform a loop cut again. Then I'm going to make it more. So next, I'm going to just use this very simple 3D model to show you how to rig it to add the skeletons. Next, you have to back to the object mode here. To add the skeletons, you just need to click add armature. Then actually, it really have an armature, but it is at the center inside here. We are going to show it. So you have to just go to the data, viewport display, to make it show in front. Then, now, you can see a skeleton is at there. Next, you make sure it is already selected. Then go to the edit mode. You can see this is the head, body, and tail. Now, first, I selected the tail and I click X so that you can view it in the XY plane. I click X. Then I select the tail, click, and this is to move it to the bottom like this. Next, I click the head, move it up to here, to the top, then click the body, then right click, subdivide, and I drag it to make it more like this. Now you can see. Next, I'm going to extend it to here. This part also need rigging. I click the head at here, then I click X to make sure it's select in that plane. I press E to extrude to that way. Then I don't click first, I press Y. Then it is going to fix in that plane. Then move to the end. Then click the body, right click, subdivide a few times like this. So now you can see it already finished the rigging process. What you need to do is just back to the object mode. We are going to bind the skin with. First, you click the 3D mesh and hold the shift, click the skeletons, the armature, then control P, just bind with the automatic width. So now it already bind with the armature. Next, you can see, just name this properly, model 01. This is the armature actually. Now you click the skeletons to show it in front. This is going to show the name. You can see the bone with the number. So click the armature, you go to the pose mode. At here, you select any of the random bones under the pose mode and you click the rotate. You can rotate it. It is really simple. Now, you can rotate. You can twist it as well. So, it is really easy. I already successfully show you the simple modeling and simple rigging process. Next is the animations. So to perform the animations, let's say if you want to shake this, all right, this one, you have to just lift it up a little bit. So let's say if you want to animate this like this, or you just want it to be up and down, how to perform this 3D animation like this? It is really simple. Control Z to just undo first. So next, what you need to do is just make sure you already select this and go to the bone. So next, at here, this one is your observations. Click and try to just manipulate the X. Now you can see this one is moving. So Control Z is to just back it. So this one, you have to just turn on the auto keying. At the same time, the X, you just click here to create a keyframe. So after 1 second, you may just make it down at this position. 1 more second, just make it up. You can see for every time you make some changes, it is going to record a keyframe here. Then 1 more second, it should be at the bottom. 1 more second, it is going to go up again. So now you can see all of this keyframe is already recorded. And the 1 second, 2 seconds, it is just counted in my heart. It is not a accurate timing, but this is just a demo. And this keyframe, you still can adjust it. So now we try to play from the beginning. You can see now it is shaking. So for this bones, you already created some keyframe, so the animation is already there. But if you click other bones, it is not recorded yet because you not yet create any keyframe at there. Let's say this one, I can start from the beginning. I try this. So the X is been manipulating. So I create a keyframe at X to record it first. After a few frames, this one, I make it down to here. I make it to here. You can see the Z is changing. It automatically recorded. After that, back to another side. Then, after a few moments here, I'm going to make the Z to become 0. Make it 0, it automatically recorded. Then, after some time, I want it to bend it here. Then, another moment, bend it to another side. Then, finally, have to just clear everything to back to the origin. Wait, Control Z, like this. So now, I try to play again. You should be able to see the animations. You can see this one is moving. You can see the animation is already there. So in this tutorial, I already show you completely the simple ones just from beginning. This is a simple 3D modeling. And after that, you create the rigs, the skeletons, the bones. Finally, I already show you how to make some simple 3D animations. Right now you can see already shaped. If you click the bones just back to the pose mode again, for this one you can see at the first frame, maybe you want to clear everything to 0. Right, this one should be at here. Try again, play. You can see the animation is already there. Alright, that's all for today. Thank you for watching. If you love my videos, tutorials, and sharings, if you feel all these tutorials and sharings are very helpful to your 3D modeling, 3D animations, and 3D game developing, you can subscribe to my YouTube channel and also turn on the mini bell and select all so that when next time I publish a new videos, tutorials, or sharings, you receive a notification immediately. See you in my next video. Enjoy! Happy 3D modeling, 3D animations, and 3D game developing. See you!